episode 3022, Chutes and Ladders.
Moms, it's time to rediscover, rejuvenate, and renew who you are in mind, body, and spirit. Welcome to Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie, the show to help you do just that. Here's your host, certified life coach, personal trainer, and nutritionist, Christiane Wargo.
Staring at a stop sign, watching people drive by.
Happy, happy day. It's Friday. Yay! I'm so excited. It's Confessions of an Upset Mama, and we are just going to have fun today. I hope you're ready for something extraordinary over the weekend. Maybe you just need to chillax a little bit. Whatever it is, I pray that the Lord blesses you immensely. But today, we got to talk about a fun game, Chutes and Ladders. For those of you who are brand new to Create Your Now, welcome to this incredible family. I'm so delighted of your presence. If you already even had the opportunity, you'll want to head on over to createyournow.com, where you can learn more and sign up for the K.I.S.S. newsletter, the Keep It Simple Strategy, Everyday Solutions to Live, Love, and Impact. Well, this episode is brought to you by AIM, Inspiring Connection and Community. All right, take a deep breath, because are you ready for this? We're going to have some fun. We're going to take it back to the classic days. How much do you wish raising kids was easier done than said? Yes, I said that exactly how I wanted it to. Everything that you think you know about children can change in a moment. It's like playing Chutes and Ladders. Do you remember that game? Well, if not, that's aging me, of course. But go to a thrift store or get on Amazon and pick it up. It's a classic. But in the game of Chutes and Ladders, right, the goal is to climb the ladders to claim your treasure, all at the same time avoiding the chute, where you slide back down and have to repeat some steps to hopefully land on a ladder again to get the chance to climb and claim the treasure. Chutes and ladders are all too familiar to us parents, isn't it? And it really is. At one point, we're flying high, understanding exactly what we're doing, yet sooner rather than later, we find ourselves lost, not knowing what to say or do. Is that not the walk of an everyday parent? Oh my, it is. That's what we live. We sit here and we're like, yes, we're on the top and we're doing awesome. And the next thing you know, we're huddled in a corner going, why, oh, why am I in this position? What did I say? What did I do? I can't handle this. You know exactly what I'm talking about. Because I know you're smiling right now. And then you're thinking, who's watching me? Because this is just not right. No, it's confession day, so it is right. You got to let this all go, because if not, you can't parent well. And the whole thing about raising a family is you want to raise your kids well. You want to be able to do the best that you can with the tools and strategies that you've been given and be able to say, okay, I'm going to do this for the time that you're underneath my roof, so that when you go out of my roof and out of my four walls that I have control over, then you can impact the world that you touch. It's a big undertaking, isn't it? I mean, come on, let's be real. However, you don't have to feel defeated and lost. Just because you think at one point you're like doing it all right, and then the next thing you know, 10 minutes later, you're like, what did I say? Yeah, I know, pins and needles, right? You're walking on glass and fire all at the same time, and you're thinking, what did I do to deserve this? You can claim the treasure. It's just how you serve the treasure you're looking for. That is your KISS to Keep It Simple strategy. Serve the treasure you're looking for. Now, that treasure are the traits you want your children to learn while under your care and supervision, while they're in your four walls, while you have them under your watch. They're the key values and morals to becoming who God designed them to be, right? You're not trying to train them up to be who you want them to be, right? You're not living vicariously through your children. That's not what we're talking about here. You're raising them up to be incredible human beings so they can go out and impact the world that they touch. So how can we as parents serve the treasure, meaning the trait, to trick the child of what awaits? I know, it's kind of a fun one, isn't it? We had to throw in a little Dr. Seuss there. Had to use some rhymes because I want you to get in and on board with this. I want you to sit there and say, you know what? I can do this. And maybe you're kind of right now on this log floating down the river and you're like, I got a lot of places to jump and I really don't know which one I should go for. Got that rock over there, got that other log floating over there, and it looks like there's a raft downstream that I might even be able to catch and might get me to the land of where I really want to go. You can serve the treasure you're searching for. But in order to do so, you first have to identify the key values and morals that lead to becoming the person God is designing your child to become, right? So that, in my opinion, is you got to get on your knees. Lord, what do you want my son to be? Who do you want him to show up as? And a lot of times we're not going to be revealed to that specifically, and we're not going to get God's blueprint of what our children should be, but you will notice things from when they were real little to now they're growing up, and you're like, ooh, I got to watch that one. Got to watch it because, man, he presses the buttons. And then you have your daughter who, well, you know, it's all about what I look like and, you know, all the feeds and everything that's coming at us, trying to be someone that we're not. What does that look like? What is that treasure that you want to find within your child? That's what you're wanting to instill within them, okay? And when you know and understand that from a parent's perspective, then you can rise up and say, okay, now I can go and take this to the next level. So what does that look like in real life to serve the treasure you're looking for? Number one, because you know what traits, the characteristics as to the morals and values you want your child to become and showcase, you got to model the behavior yourself. You have no choice. Children learn best by example. So make sure you're modeling the traits you want your child to learn. If you want your child to be kind, make a point to show kindness to others on a daily basis. Your child does what he or she sees. And if they're seeing you mad all the time, guess what? You think they're going to be mad a lot? Yes, they are. Because that is what is modeled to them. So if you want them to be kind, then be kind not just to strangers, be kind to the people within your four walls. Now, yes, you're going to have moments where your head's going to blow off and you're just mad and you're going to say things. Yeah, you ask for forgiveness because that's real life, right? But I'm talking about for the majority of our life and how we interact, we can be kind if we choose. So show that kindness in your family, to strangers, to your colleagues, to your children's teachers, whoever you come in contact with. Be kind, okay? Whatever it is, you've got to model that behavior, because if you don't, then they're not going to know and won't take the cues because you're not giving them the cues. So you got to show them, right? You've got to live it out first, and which is, whoo, let me tell you, this is a whole eye-opening experience. When you have a child, you're looking in the mirror. You heard me correctly. I have five of them. That's a lot of mirrors to look at, let me tell you. And boy, have they humbled this heart, because I see the good, the bad, and the ugly in my children, which means what? I see the good, bad, and the ugly in me. So it's important that we know and recognize that so we can make things better. We can learn, we can grow from them. And then we can go from that point on and make a difference so we can impact the world that we touch. So model the behavior yourself. Number two, reinforce the positive. You've got to reinforce good behavior every chance you get. Reward them. Now, it doesn't mean you have to go buy them something. I didn't say that. You know, our times right now, money's a little tight. I get it. So you don't have to go and say, well, I'm going to buy you $200 shoes or $300 pair of jeans or whatever. You don't have to do that. You can acknowledge and be specific about what they did to accomplish something so great, which maybe to them was not really a big deal. But in the long run, it is huge, absolutely huge. Model the behavior yourself, reinforce the positive. Number three, make it a daily habit. Consistency is key. Make a point to teach and reinforce good character traits on a daily basis. Now, initially, this is going to take some thought, because you're really going to have to say, okay, what do I want to focus on? So my suggestion would be is to pick one trait and focus on the one. Now, hopefully you're thinking about all of this all at the same time, but you're growing too when you do this. Okay, this isn't just about your kids. You realize that, right? Remember, your children are a reflection of you. Yeah, I know, kind of scary. Like I said, I have five of them, and it's really scary. And some of them are really, really, really big mirrors. And I'm thinking, Lord, that was not very nice of you. And he just, I know he's got a sense of humor and he's laughing. And I'm saying, I don't like it, but okay, I have to deal with it. So make it a daily habit. Over time, I promise you, as you do it more, consistency becomes the main player in the game of chutes and ladders, right? It's going to become a habit for your child. Number four. Use stories and visuals. So you can tell a story, and you can make up a story, by the way. Did you ever know that? You could just like tell a story. They won't know that you didn't get it from anywhere. And you can use, their own experiences and just change the names and add in some fun stuff and a bunny rabbit or a deer or a horse or something like that. And all of a sudden, it's not real life, but it teaches real life to them. Yeah, so if my children are listening, you just heard a secret. You can use it on your children eventually, which will be my grandchildren. Anyway, I know they listen every once in a while, so I have to just put that out there because they're learning all my secrets. But that's a good thing. It's a good thing because now they're older and they need to know these secrets. And we do have these honest conversations. You know, that now that we have grandbabies and our families are grown because of our children are growing, it's awesome because they get to go and create their families, and they get to figure out what kind of family they want to have, and what does that look like, and what morals and traits, and what do they want to highlight in their everyday. It's important. So when you're looking at stories and visuals and books, you can look at TV shows. I know it's hard to find some good ones. You can even look at movies. Did you know there's some incredible, great movies out there right now? One of them is Big George Foreman. It actually releases today, April 28th, in theaters. Go out and see it. It is going to be spectacular. I've heard some things behind the scenes. It's great. And we all need one of those kind of stories in our life. And this one is based on Big George Foreman. So it's based on his story. And so when you can use real life stories, which there are a lot out there now because of our technology and advancements, we can find those things a lot faster. And so you can find a story that's going to touch your child's heart. So let's say your child's a little bit older and they are really interested in the military. And in fact, they're thinking about enlisting in the military. Great. Then find some great people in the military, some heroes. There's tons of books out there. And share those stories. And it doesn't have to be read the whole book, son. It can be a three sentence or two. Like seriously, it could be a paragraph, or you read the book first and have it laying out and just mark some things. Believe it or not, curiosity didn't kill a cat. It helps the cat grow. So that means your child, if your son's interested, your daughter's interested, right? And you lay that book out there and they'll look at it and be like, well, what's this, mom? And then it'll just stay there. Just leave it there. Just don't let anything pile up around it. And then eventually when you're not looking, they'll pick it up and they'll be like, well, what is she reading? Curiosity, right? It's a good thing. There's a lot of learning when our children are curious, and we want them to be curious in the right manner. We could talk about that forever. So use those stories and books and visual aids to help your children understand the importance of the traits you are trying to instill in them, right? If you are wanting to teach them honesty, read a story about a character who learns the value of telling the truth. And then what you're instilling in them isn't just coming from you, right? It is reinforced, and it's backed up by other people's stories, which is absolutely a wonderful thing. And then finally, number five, create opportunities to practice. Practice makes progress. Give your child opportunities to practice the traits you want to teach them. So if you're trying to teach patience, I love this one. Give your child a puzzle to work on. That's going to require patience and perseverance to complete. Now, give them an age-appropriate puzzle. If they're 5 years old, don't give them a 1,000-piece puzzle to do, right? Give them a 20-piece puzzle if they're 5 years old. But if they're 12 years old, yeah, go to 500 or 1,000-piece puzzle. But make sure you're not flustered by having the puzzle pieces all over the place, right? So put it in an area that it can stay out for a few weeks, maybe even a month or so. And it allows them to see what there's a mess here of lots of little pieces, but when you work, eventually it becomes something. And there's a lot of big teachable moments in puzzles. Your children will only rise to the level at which you invite them to excel. Think about that for a moment. Your child will only rise to the level of which you invite him or her to excel. If your ceiling and floor are equal, your child is not going to have as great of a chance to soar. But if you set your floor as your foundation and raise your ceiling, then your child will rise up to what they know is possible, even when it's impossible. Serving the treasure, the traits you want your child to learn, is all about intentional parenting. You can, my friend, effectively teach your child the values and morals they need to become the person God designed them to be. You just got to be patient with yourself and believe. Go out, be present, be incredible, be you. I love you so very much. I cannot wait to see you on the other side. Blessings, hugs, and lots of love. We'll talk to you real soon. Have a glorious, blessed weekend. Bye-bye.
Feeling inspired, ready to train for life, and love your journey? Visit createyournow.com for more incredible resources to help you along the way. We'll see you next time on Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie. And remember, always be sure you consult your physician before beginning any health and fitness plan.